Welcome to this video on polynomials. In the previous video, we learned about division of polynomials and remainder theorem. Today, we will solve some questions related to the remainder theorem. So, let's start with our first question. Divide the polynomial 8x cubed plus 2x squared minus 5x minus 7 by a linear polynomial 2x minus pi to find the remainder. We have to first ensure that the given polynomial is arranged in the descending order of its powers. Yes, this polynomial is in descending order. Now, write it in the division format. While writing, be careful and take the linear polynomial to the divisor place and the polynomial with higher powers to the dividend place. Friends, don't get worried looking at it. We just have to follow the steps discussed in the previous video. Now let's start the division. To begin with, we will focus on the first terms of both polynomials. When we divide 8x cubed by 2x, we will get 4x squared. We will write this in the quotient place. Now multiply the quotient with all the terms of the divisor and subtract the product from our polynomial. On subtracting, 8x cubed minus 8x cubed will become 0 and 2x squared plus 4pi x squared will add up to form 2x squared plus 4pi x squared. We can take 2x squared common and write it as 1 plus 2pi multiplied by 2x squared. With this, we will carry the remaining terms of the dividend with their signs below. Now again, divide 1 plus 2pi multiplied by 2x squared by 2x and see what we will get. We will get 1 plus 2pi multiplied by x, which we will write in the quotient place and multiply it with the divisor. When we multiply 1 plus 2pi multiplied by x with 2x, we will get 1 plus 2pi multiplied by 2x squared, and on multiplying 1 plus 2pi multiplied by x with minus pi, we will get minus pi plus 2pi squared multiplied by x. Friends, while subtracting, the first term will reduce to 0, but we will have to give proper attention to the remaining terms. From minus 5x and plus pi plus 2pi squared multiplied by x, we will take x as common and we will write everything else in brackets, which will be pi plus 2pi squared minus 5 multiplied by x. Now we are left with minus 7, which we will bring down. We will repeat the same process until we get a constant polynomial or 0 as the remainder. Divide pi plus 2pi squared minus 5 multiplied by x by 2x and we will get pi plus 2pi squared minus 5 divided by 2. We will write this in the quotient. Now multiply this term with the divisor and subtract the product so obtained from the polynomial. On multiplying, we get the first term because we have done the calculations keeping that in mind. On multiplying with minus pi, we will get minus pi square plus 2 pi cube minus 5 pi divided by 2. On subtracting, the signs will change and we will get the remainders minus 7 and pi square plus 2 pi cube minus 5 pi divided by 2, which together will become pi square plus 2 pi cube minus 5 pi divided by 2 minus 7. Friends, if we carefully observe the remainder, there is no term with variable x. This means we have got a constant polynomial and hence the division is now complete. So we can say that pi square plus 2 pi cube minus 5 pi divided by 2 minus 7 is the remainder. This is the solution to this question using long division method. Now let's see the solution using remainder theorem. Let's assume p of x is a polynomial with degree greater than or equal to 1. And a is a real number. If the polynomial p of x is divided by a linear polynomial x minus a, the remainder we get is p of a. Let's compare this with our example. Here we are dividing the polynomial p of x by a linear polynomial x minus pi by 2. We got the remainder p of pi by 2 as pi square plus 2 pi cube minus 5 pi divided by 2 minus 7. Now let's move to the second question. State whether the given linear polynomial x minus 1 by 3 is a factor of the polynomial x cubed minus 10 by 3x squared plus 3x minus 2 by 3. If on dividing the two polynomials we get the remainder as 0, then we can say that the linear polynomial is a factor of the given polynomial. But how to find the remainder without carrying out the division procedure? Yes, we can. If we equate the linear polynomial with 0, we will get the value for x. Now, on substituting the value of x in the given polynomial, we can determine its remainder. So let's do it. On equating x minus 1 by 3 to 0, we will get the root of this equation, that is, x is equal to 1 by 3. And now we will find p of 1 by 3. We got p of 1 by 3 as 0. What does this mean? This means x minus 1 by 3 is a factor of the polynomial x cubed minus 10 by 3x squared plus 3x minus 2 by 3. So friends, with this let's end our video. In this video, we solved a few examples related to the remainder theorem. See you in the next video with some more interesting questions. Thank you.